What up, dude? Crypto Warriors, this is Ultra Crypto, back at it again. Today is Saturday, July 18th, 2020. Happy birthday, kid. For any new technology, there's always controversy and there's always some fear associated with it. I think that's just the price of being first sometimes. This is coming from Hugh Grant, English actor, and I'm going to relate it to what I'm going to cover today. Ethereum 2.0 upgrade and Cardano's Shelley. Let's get into it. Ethereum 2.0 off track. Phase zero most likely to release in 2021. If you've been in this space for at least a couple of years, you've heard about this ETH 2.0 upgrade and them moving from proof of work to proof of stake. It still hasn't happened yet, and we're still waiting here. Don't hold your breath, okay? ETH 2.0 behind schedule as Ethereum 2.0 researcher expects phase zero to release in January 2021. However, Vitalik Buterin urges the release of phase zero in 2020. He's still hoping that we have a release in 2020. Ethereum 2.0 long overdue. The Ethereum community has been awaiting the network's biggest update for the longest time now. ETH 2.0, also known as Serenity, would initiate the transition of the Ethereum network from proof of work to proof of stake. This significant network update would address several issues, including scalability as well as privacy. The Ethereum 2.0's phase zero was scheduled to release sometime in Q1 2020. However, that boat had sailed, and the network's team revealed another delay of ETH 2.0. They're saying right now January 3rd, 2021. They pretty much said the same thing back in 2019, that it was going to be 2020. In January of 2020, then they said no, it's going to be the first quarter of in 2020, and they just keep delaying it. I've used this example before where if you're trying to upgrade a vehicle, right, you're not going to do that while the vehicle is on. You're not going to change the wheels. You're not going to change the transmission or change the engine out and swap it out for a bigger, stronger turbocharged engine. Vroom, vroom, right? You're not going to change it out while the engine is moving. That vehicle has to stop. And then you do your upgrades. Then you change the wheel. However, being that this is software and this is a decentralized system, they can't do that. They cannot do that. They can't just stop it, come to a full stop, because that's $26 billion on the line here. They can't just come to a full stop and say, all right, well, we're going to upgrade it. Give us a few months and then we'll be back. They can't do that. They have to do that upgrade over time. The mistake they keep making is they keep giving us a date. They keep giving us a date, and as investors in the project, we're expecting it to happen by said date, because you guys are the developers, the researchers, you know, the brains of the situation here. You keep giving us these dates. However, there's always a delay. Stop giving dates. Don't give a date until everything has been tested, you know, from ABC to XYZ has been, and everything in between has been tested and retested and retested. Check, check, check and check. Don't give us dates and then not expect people not to be upset. Again, this is like a moving vehicle, and you can't expect them to stop it, to work on it, because it's software and it's a decentralized system. We are seeing that there's maybe some kind of infighting within the group here, because we have the founder and, you know, Vitalik Buterin saying that the phase zero of 2.0 is going to be released in 2020, but researchers are saying no, that has to be pushed back until at least January of 2021 because of, you know, the holiday season, which is Thanksgiving and then Christmas right afterwards, and people are going to be want a time off and all that stuff. Understandable. You want to spend time with your family and all that, but again, don't give us a date, man. Don't tell us anything. I think they should just, once everything has been tested and everything has been proven, then the testnet has been up and running and all the bugs, as much bugs as possible, have been found and fixed then you just release it. Don't even give us a date. That's the way how I would go about it. But you know, again, I'm not a developer here. I'm not a researcher. I'm just, you know, giving my two satoshis on this situation. The release of ETH 2.0 has been constantly delayed. As the community is running out of patience, the coordination between the members also seems to be taking a hit. Again, there seems to be a little infighting within the team over there, and we'll see what happens. We'll see if it comes out by the end of 2020 or 2021, or they'll just keep delaying it again. Again, these things take time, and we have to be patient. Next, I got mad long-winded on that, and I'm sorry, but you know, I had to explain it. Messari CEO Cardano has plenty of room for growth. This is coming from Cointelegraph. Again, great with the artwork. I love it. After Cardano surged to become sixth biggest cryptocurrency by market cap last week, Messari co-founder and CEO Ryan Selkis still believes traders could buy and stake more of the altcoin. In his newsletter, Selkis said lower staking rates for Cardano, ADA, could mean a higher reward payout for investors who are wondering if they're late to the party. No, you're definitely not late to the party. I'm not financial advice, of course, but we're still super early, and I'm gonna probably throw up a chart here with Cardano's price all-time high and all that, and we are far off from it and still plenty of room to grow as far as the price action is concerned when we're considering the previous all-time highs for it to get back there. So again, not financial advice. The Messari co-founder says one of the catalysts for the token's recent surge, up 85% as of July 8th, is Shelly, an upcoming possible hard fork upgrading its ecosystem. The potential discrepancies between staked and unstaked ADA, however, could bode well for bulls even after Shelly goes live. While the initial staking percentage won't be known until after launch, Cardano's incentivized testnet saw participation from 40% of the reported supply. If this carries over to mainnet, Cardano's staking rates will be significantly lower than the other large cap networks like Tezos and Cosmos. Tezos staking rate right now is at 80%. They have 80% of their circulating supply staked, and Cosmos have 71% staked. Good news as far as Cardano, because Cardano during the testnet phase was only 40% staked. So they could double that up and go to 80%, as we see here in Tezos. Right now, the price is fluctuating around 13 cents. Again, plenty of room to grow when you consider the all-time high. I think the all-time high was maybe a dollar or $1.20 or something like that. And yeah, plenty of room to grow as far as that is concerned. Again, but with Cardano, as we saw, it took time for them to get to this phase. Cardano was released during the bull run of 2020. Fall of 2017. I am jumping the bull run, baby. I am so excited for this bull run to start. But Cardano was released during the last bull run in 2017, in the fall of 2017. And we're finally here right now, 3 years later, or almost 3 years later, to the point where of a mainnet release. So these things, again, takes time. The thing, going back to the last article, going back to Ethereum with the ETH 2.0, these things take time, and ETH have so much built on it. Cardano have zero built on it right now. They just have their network, and that's it. They have a lot of partnerships, but they don't have any dApps on it right now. They don't have any, not only dApps, but DeFi and things of that nature working on the network currently, using the protocol currently. So it's, I think, a lot easier for Cardano to implement upgrades and have them hit their target dates a lot faster and easier because they have nothing built on it right now. With Ethereum, that's another thing happening because they actually have dApps, DeFi, different governance situations happening all over the network and attached to the protocol. So if they screw it up again, that's a lot of billions of dollars being gone. Like just with the Ethereum protocol alone, that's $26 billion with all the DeFi and all the dApps and CryptoKitties and all that stuff. That's over $33 billion. So you're looking at, you know, well into the, what, $50, $60 billion range when you talk about trying to upgrade ETH 2.0 starting over here. Sorry about that. But yeah, that what I think is the big difference right now with Cardano versus Ethereum. Cardano has zero built on it. However, so that makes it a lot easier for them to do the upgrade. Ethereum, on the other hand, they have a lot of stuff built on it and they can't screw it up. That's just, again, my opinion. I'm not, you know, I'm new to this developing game. So again, my opinion. Next story real quick before I go. Elon Musk sees Doge standard future. And here's a tweet. And it surged 14%. Yo, this dude is the ultimate troll. You know, like, it's so funny. And here's a tweet. I liked it. You know, Dogecoin standard global financial system. This is super duper funny. And yeah, people are just pumping Doge, man. You can always count on Doge to get a good pump during any bull market scenario. You know, let me know what you guys think. Smash that like, hit that subscribe button, the notification bell. You know, if you stuck it out with me stuttering because I'm super excited, thank you. And happy birthday to my son again. And yeah, it's Sergeant Crypto and I'm out. Peace.